a nuclear world. Imagine a world where the power to annihilate entire cities lies at the fingertips of a single few select nations. This is the reality we live in today, where nuclear warheads hang like a sword of Damocles over our heads, promising both devastation and deterrence. In this talk, we will explore the pros and cons of having nuclear warheads in our world today. Peace. Let's consider the concept of deterrence. The presence of nuclear warheads has arguably prevented major conflicts between nuclear-armed states since World War II. This balance of terror, known as mutually assured destruction, creates a reluctance to engage in all-out war, thereby maintaining a fragile peace. Another advantage of nuclear warheads is the potential of peaceful applications, such as energy production. Nuclear power plants generate electricity without producing greenhouse gases, offering a cleaner alternative to fossil fuels and helping combat climate change. However, the existence of nuclear warheads also raises serious humanitarian concerns. The devastation caused by a single nuclear bomb is unimaginable, with long-lasting effects on human health, the environment, and entire ecosystems. The use of nuclear weapons provides and would violate humanitarian law and could lead to catastrophic consequences. The proliferation of nuclear warheads also poses a security risk. The more countries who possess these weapons, the greater the chance of them falling into the wrong hands, whether through theft, sabotage, or accidental launch. This risk is compounded by the emergence of non-state actors who may seek to acquire nuclear capabilities for their own destructive purposes. According to the Arms Control Association, there are approximately 13,080 nuclear warheads in the world, with the United States and Russia holding the majority. Despite a decrease in the peak of the Cold War, the sheer number of warheads remains a cause for concern. Consider the story of Sutisko Thurlow, a survivor of the atomic bombing of Hiroshima and Nagasaki. In 1945, Sutisko Thurlow was a 13-year-old schoolgirl when the bomb was dropped, killing her entire family and leaving her trapped under the rubble for hours before being rescued. Sutisko has since dedicated her life to advocating for nuclear disarmament, sharing her harrowing experience to prevent such horrors from happening again. How do we balance these pros and cons? The answer lies in responsible nuclear stewardship. Nations must work together to reduce the number of nuclear warheads, strengthening non-proliferation efforts, and invest in diplomacy to resolve conflicts. Additionally, we must continue to pursue alternative energy sources to lessen our dependence on nuclear power plants, posing a conclusion. Additionally, we must continue alternative energy sources to lessen our dependence on nuclear power is up to us. It is up to us as a global community, not only our leaders, but the leaders all over the world, to come together and come to a resolve. We as a people must understand what these nuclear power, like nuclear warheads, the like amount of power that they have. One drop on Nagasaki and Hiroshima almost took out the entire country of Japan. And since then, Russia, the United States, and China have built upon these nuclear warheads, meaning that they're a lot stronger, they're a lot bigger. The nuclear warheads we have now can amount to 64 kilotons, I believe. The ones that were dropped on Nagasaki and Hiroshima were only 4 kilotons, meaning that just one of these bombs to be dropped would create catastrophic damage throughout the entire world and may just lead to world devastation. That's why us as a world need to come together to form a deterrence of these nuclear warheads. Thank you.